I first sought Jesus when I was 5 years old. There was a little church next to my mom's business, and it was a retirement home business, and we lived in it. And I loved going to church there, but I don't remember it being a family occasion where we all went together. So I remember sitting in this little Sunday school room and singing, "Jesus loves me, yes I know." And I just remember loving the community and being there, and everyone was so kind. My parents divorced right before that. They divorced when I was 3. And my brother lived with my dad in LA, and I lived here in Redlands with my mom. And we were a family that believed in God and Jesus, but we weren't a family that went to church regularly. And spiritually, I didn't know Jesus. You know, I knew about Easter and I knew about the resurrection, but I didn't really understand it. And we didn't talk about it, and I didn't know the Lord. When I was 10, my mom married a man who was abusive to me. And she repeated his ugly words when she said, "When you're dead, you're 6 feet under." Like, that's it, end of discussion. And there was no discussion. Even after she left this man, we didn't talk about it. I didn't understand. I just knew it made me feel empty. Some more time went by. I grew up, went to college, had 2 girls, divorced when they were 3 and 5. And about that time, my mom became a Christian. And she had retired, and she became a Christian and found a church home. And that was really a great thing in her life. And she wasn't super happy when I didn't, you know, join her there. She really wanted me to come and learn, become a Christian. And I was busy with work and raising kids and work. Yeah. And, you know, and so the next time I sought the Lord was maybe 5 or 6 years ago. I went to a Christmas tea that Elizabeth spoke at, and I remember her saying, "Jesus is your one true love, and he will never forsake you." Even though I was in Trinity and I went to more than one Christmas teas, and I knew people that went to church there and I liked being there, I just didn't take any action. Yeah. I understood the concept of sin when you explained to me that it's just something you do wrong, you know, big or little, and that was in Bible study. That I needed a Savior, I think I always knew that. Yeah. I just didn't act on it. Mm-hmm. You know, I knew through the years I needed that. When I was young, I sought it out. But I always knew in the back of my mind I didn't have a Christ-centered home. Yes. My daughter Krista was going to Biola University. She was applying, and the counselor called to interview her, and she went in her room and closed the door. And I went and I listened at the door, what is she saying in there? And I remember hearing her say, "I'm not from a Christian home." And oh, that was so cutting. A few months later, we were standing in her doorway of her room again and just seeing the tears well up in her eye. We were talking about something about the Lord, and I got it. You know, I just saw the pain in her eyes when she knew her sister and I would not have an everlasting life. She had sought him, she had found him, she had an ongoing relationship with him, and I didn't. And so it was that pain in her gut that made me talk to my friend who I knew went to Trinity, and so then I joined your Bible study group, and it's been a great home since. So this is my 4th year, coming to end of my 4th year, and you know, it's the best thing ever. I love John 6:35 when Jesus said, "I am the bread of life. He who comes to me will never go hungry. He who believes in me will never be thirsty."